A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You drew me, O Lord, and let myself be drew. You were too strong for me, and you tried. All the day I am an object of love. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. Jesus turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct. Friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Just a little comment before I begin. I was very touched by the first reading that was read by a young boy here. I did get his name in the sacristy. But I think it's always nice to hear different voices read at Mass. Young, old, men, women, and so forth. And so this is my suggestion to our chapel committee, that perhaps it would be good because it tells us who are with us. End of editorial remark. Whoever wishes to come after me must deny oneself, take up one's cross, and follow me. We often hear this call of Jesus and think we know what it means. But what does it mean if you are a high-ranking official in business, government, or even the church? Or a family broken by betrayal or separated in Marawi? Or parents of Kian de los Santos or the victims of Hurricane Harvey? Or, for our athletes here, an Ateneo varsity team hoping for its breakout season, or an athlete sidelined with ACL, watching his teammates practice. What do these words of Jesus mean? Perhaps they simply mean that life is hard and full of unforeseen, unavoidable challenges from nature and our own doing. Wherever we may be, we cannot escape from sweat, even blood and tears. Whether we are working on a hurting personal relationship, a business proposal for work or school, a goal to be met. The mantra of athletes go, no pain, no gain. And so too it seems with the rest of life. Hence, St. Ignatius even speaks of spiritual exercises, what needs to be done repeatedly and wholeheartedly if we are to grow spiritually and become better persons.
For our tulong dunong community, that in the gratitude we continue to be testament of God's generosity and mercy, and to participate in the mission of peace and justice, we pray.
Father, hear our prayer.
For our student athletes, that they may always play with courage and dignity, live out Ignatian values and valor on and off the court for the greater glory of God, we pray.
Father, hear our prayer.
For all of us, Lord, help us to live simply and in self-sacrifice so that we can become good stewards and thus make holy your creation. We pray.
Father, hear our prayer.
Thank you.
reminder of your love. As we bless our athletes, their uniforms, we pray for them, their coaches, their support staff, so that their efforts be fruitful, their bodies strong and free from injury, their minds sharp and keen, their hearts enduring and united in spirit. Most of all, we beg you, Lord, that they always clothe themselves, as St. Paul says, in sincere compassion, in kindness and humility, in gentleness and patience, bearing with one another and putting on Christ. All this we pray with Mary, our patron, in the name of Jesus and the Spirit, forever and ever. Amen.
Thanks be to God.